that fire over there? It's really close to our campground. I hope nothing happens. See all those campers? Uh-oh.
Stuff.
Let's find out what stuff means.
Yeah.
What did we order?
We ordered fried mushrooms and steak and stuff. Cobb salad, which we're going to split.
Do you think it's going to be good?
I hope it's going to be good. We never know. That's why we come to these places. Sometimes it's a pleasant surprise. Sometimes it's not.
Mm-hmm. Is it good?
It is good. These fried mushrooms are really good.
Here's a half-bit one.
It smells really good. We haven't tried it yet, but I'm sure it's going to be awesome. Can
The food here was super good. Crisp, clean, refreshing. Anything that was breaded or fried, like the mushrooms, was super good. So I recommend coming here. It's great. Here we are in Old Town Cottonwood. It's pretty hot today, but let's go check it out. It doesn't look open. Estrada?
Yeah, this says it's the most fun place.
It's gotta be wine, huh? Sure.
Okay.
Looks so pretty.
Number one for 3 years.
That's grapes.
Oh, I never seen yours get so big.
Oh, you see all the time.
The leaves like that get big?
Oh, they're even bigger than that.
What? Oh, look. Look.
You got the baby down there?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Right. This guy's been driving way too long. I use the phone like this. I bet you haven't. One like this, and it was a fish tank. Remember that, Mom? Do you remember this, Mom? Bacon grease? Yours was much bigger. I I definitely had this. Does anybody remember the TV series Friday the 13th? It used to consist of this couple that used to pick up old artifacts, and they used to be haunted because there would be a ghost attached to something. Well, I'll tell you what, that chair right here, this was a surgical chair in the asylum. I tell you right now, if something's haunted, that's your guy right there. So I'm gonna stay away from that.
Alright. People come from all over the world to see the world's largest Kokopelli. Here it is.
It's not that big.
Here we are at Mai Tai on Main Street in Cottonwood, Arizona. And holy cow, this place is the bomb. We had the chicken satay and the Penang curry, and they make it as good as the best places we've been. It's just amazing here. And even better, the satay had other sauces that we've never had before. So make sure you come here. These are awesome. Chicken satay, and one of the reasons why we came back here.
Coconut curry. It's cooked in a coconut curry, and it has these cool sauces with it.
Very yummy.
This looks good. It's the beef salad, chicken penang,
which we already know is amazing.
And the guy who's gonna eat it all at level 5. Me too. Yeah. Let's share.
Yeah, let's share.
Oh, look, it's before it was excavated, man. Thank you.
You should take your mask off.
There, it says how many people that we have. I would like to see that number again.
Just a rubble hill, rubbled hill at once.
Snakes. I missed one or two.
How do you think they got from one room to another? How do you think they got from one room to another? Huh? Ladders? Thank you.
Hmm? It said spam. I think that's from Kentucky.
That doesn't mean anything. Scam likely has been reported many of times as scams. Just because they're calling you from Kentucky doesn't mean anything. That way we don't have to have your butt in the whole picture. I found that frustrating when we were hiking with Jeffrey. I always had Jeffrey's ass and everything.
So they all were like this. This is pretty cool. So here we are trying a black bear diner. Let's find out what the black bear is gonna get.
They have some kind of a thing. I gotta find out if it's real or not. But on here it says the biggest burger is 10 ounce blah 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 blah. Well, supposedly they have something that's 2 10 ounce patties. But I gotta see if that's real or not.
It's for Father's Day.
Oh yeah. It's a Father's Day
special.
Let's see if that's real. If so, we'll have to share it because that's a lot.
Definitely.
yourself visiting here over 7 centuries ago and receiving an invitation into this cliff-dwelling home, what you would have seen might well have been something like this cutaway model of Montezuma Castle. On the top floor, the elderly village lookout keeps his solitary vigil. His eyes search for approaching danger to those working the fields below the castle. It seems that over the ages, children and their actions change very little. On the fourth floor, you'll find a concerned mother scurrying to reach her adventuresome son, precariously balanced on the edge of the roof. On the third floor, an aging man leads his blind wife across the balcony. You'll also meet women busily preparing food, getting supplies from storerooms, making pottery and grinding corn. Usually women ground the corn, their staple food, only in small as needed quantities and prepared it in various ways. Weavers use the second floor loom to weave cotton breech cloths, bags, and blankets. Today, you can see examples of their varied weaving patterns in the visitor center. Villagers use the wooden ladders as stairways to carry up provisions from fields and water from Beaver Creek. On the ledge at the base of the central tower-like section, a man prepares to start a fire using a friction drill. Nearby, a young woman awaits the returning hunters who bring wild game as variety to the village diet. We encourage you to think beyond ancient stone walls and vacant rooms to the remains of a once vibrant village. A village of people who experienced wants and needs, anxieties and fears, joys and sorrows, just as you and I today.
At the park.
The reality. It's amazing because the natives told the cavalry when they got here in the 1800s, told them, oh, the people want to see the fire. Get thousands and thousands of migrants both coming, you know, heading from north to south and then from south to north again. Yeah, lots and lots of migrants. In December.